How do you think we end the stigma surrounding suicide?
Well, by talking about it. You know, Chris, for 30 years, I never talked publicly about how my father died. I was 19 years old. I was a student at the University of Chicago. A police officer came to my apartment and knocked on the door. My roommate was reluctant to let him in, it being the 70s. And I said, no, let him in. And he said, are you David Axelrod? I said, yes. He says, your father, Joseph Axelrod. I said, yes. And I knew when he asked that question that something terrible had happened. And he told me that my father had committed suicide and I needed to go back to New York. The NYPD wanted me to come and identify the body. And it was just a stunning, surreal, horrific event. But I didn't talk about it. I didn't talk about it for years and years and years because somehow I thought it besmirched my father's memory to talk about how he died. And I finally realized that was all wrong, that it was exactly that that caused him not to get the help he needed. And by the way, he was a mental health professional, but he helped other people, but he didn't reach out for help himself, didn't feel like he could reach out for help himself. And I wrote a piece in the Chicago Tribune on Father's Day in 2006 talking about this. And I got the greatest outpouring of letters and calls from people all over the country telling me that, you know, they've either been struggling with depression or they lost someone to suicide and right. They didn't think they could talk about it. We've got to talk about these things. And maybe the one thing that will come out of these tragic deaths of Tony Bourdain and Kate Spade is that we'll have a more public discussion because we have an epidemic of suicide in this country and we need to do something about it.